Hello everyone. As you probably know, Azure Global Cloud spans over 60 announced regions more than any other cloud provider. Today we will learn how to connect VNets across all these regions using Global VNet Peering. Stay tuned. Before talking about VNet Peering, I want to do a quick recap about what we have configured up to now. For those who didn't watch the previous videos, I strongly recommend you to find the links of those videos in the description of this video and watch them, because we already discussed the most fundamental components of Azure networking, like VNets, Subnets, and private DNS. Guys, as you can see in the left part of the screen, we created three VNets and we configured several subnets within them. Each VNet is located in different region. We use Southeast Asia, East US, and also West Europe for each VNet. We also configured private DNS in order to have kind of an automatic and dynamic management for each VNet and all the resources that either establish or remove within that VNet. We also linked all VNets, all three VNets that we already created. And now it's time to talk about the theoretical things behind VNet peering. I promise you keep it as short as possible because we want to experience Azure by deploying each and every component. Guys, VNet peering acts as a bridge. It is either global or regional. What I mean is you can connect two VNets within a region, or you can connect several VNets in different regions. It acts somehow globally and regionally. Guys, VNet peering totally take advantages of the Azure backbone, so your data remains safe. And you can also peer across subscription and tenants, so it is something that gives you unlimited power to connect VNets together. Now, let's get our hands dirty and do the configuration. First, let's check current resource group. Inside the resource group, we can see all the resource and components that we either manually created or they got deployed automatically. What I mean, just consider some of these network security group or network interface card for VMs. I didn't personally configure them. Whenever I created the VM itself, the network interface card got deployed. The reason why I'm telling you that some resources get deployed automatically by Azure whenever you create and establish a new resource. Then keep this point in mind. I didn't create any network security group myself. I didn't create any kind of network interface card myself. All of them are there after I created the resource like VM. In the previous video, I created two virtual machines in core services VNet. Let's check them. Can you see there are two test VMs? I created them to confirm the functionality of private DNS zone, so we can take advantage of them and don't create any other virtual machine in the core service VNet on the left side of the screen. And now I'm going to create another VM in manufacturing VNet. I will call it manufacturing VM. As I already explained it, in order to keep it as short as possible, I'm going to use template using Azure Cloud Shell. First, let's upload the files. The first command that we need to execute is to define the resource group as our variable. Hit enter, and then we should execute the last command, which take advantage of ARM template in order to create the VM in the manufacturing VNet. The VM got deployed, yet the name is manufacturing VM, that's right. The size is standard D2ASV5 and username is test user. So everything seems fine. And now let's connect to the VM and see what happens if I want to try ping or test connectivity or establish something like remote desktop from manufacturing VM to the test VM in core services VNet. Guys, I want to connect from this VNet, which I just created, to the test VM in core service VNet. Let's check it. Okay, manufacturing VM. Now I want to take note the private IP address of the VM. I can see the public IP address, but my intention is not using public IP address, is to use private IP address. I mentioned that my intention is using the Azure backbone. As I mentioned, I want to take advantage of the power of Azure backbone because it has the least latency, the best connectivity time. So let's just take a note of this IP address. And now it's time to connect to manufacturing VM. Now let's use PowerShell to test the connectivity. Guys, currently I'm trying to connect using port 3389 TCP, which is used for remote desktop, to see the connectivity between the manufacturing VM and the test VM in another VNet. Eventually, it provides you with somehow comprehensive report about what happened there. So the result is quite crystal clear. There is no connectivity between these two VMs. Now we are going to connect them by using VNet peering. We need to pick one of the VNets. Then we need to go under settings, peerings, and hit add. Can you see here we can configure it as a kind of bi-directional connectivity by configuring remote virtual network summary and at the bottom of the screen local virtual network summary. I'm going to name it core VNet to manufacturing VNet. For the virtual network, I'm going to the manufacturing VNet. Guys, it quite makes sense because I'm trying to connect core service here on the left side of the screen to the manufacturing, and I want to make it a bi-directional connectivity. Then here, there are a couple of interesting options. The first option says, let core service VNet to access manufacturing VNet. So it makes sense, I'm going to pick it up. It's already configured by default. And the second one says, allow core services VNet to receive forwarding traffic from manufacturing VNet. I want it. Why not? And also here, you just hit the checkbox for both of them. Keep in mind that I don't have any kind of gateway, neither network virtual appliance, nor Azure related gateway within these VNets for now. Then I can just leave the last two options. In order to make it as clear as possible, I just hit the same name for the local and remote virtual network summary and then hit add. Okay. Can you see? Currently, I'm under core service VNet. Under peering, it shows everything works fine, the configuration already applied. But let's go under other VNet, which is the manufacturing VNet. Can you see here, guys? The core service VNet to manufacturing was already configured here because I just created one VNet peering from core services VNet, then it could automatically created it here under peering. Under manufacturing VNet. So now we should be able to connect from manufacturing VNet to test VM in core service VNet here. From this VM to this VM. Let's check it. Open the VM, remove the subconsole, and let's see. Then I'm on manufacturing VM, and let's perform the test. It connected swiftly. All the tests passed. I have currently removed the subconnectivity from manufacturing VNet to the test VM on core services VNet. It is end of our video. I hope it was informative for you. Please hit the like and subscribe my channel for more Azure related content.